Here we are out on the Mount Perry Road, heading out to Mount Perry for a weekend adventure. There's Mark, the driver, his camper van here. Might enjoy some little bit of gold prospecting, but also some coin and relic hunting. Got a lot of history of this area out through here, but dating back to the 1860s, 1870s, 1880s. Churches and schools and gold mining and race courses and swimming holes. So yeah, just an adventure to relax and enjoy. Here's a little bit of history from the place here. We've had to go through a 192 meter tunnel through the rocks. Look at that. 1883 to 1884. Much more raw than this. Wow. Feel that.
Oh, the bats.
Wow, look at all the bats. Got the window open here, so one of these bats might decide to be come for a free ride in the van. I'm sleeping outside anyway. You might have one nibbling on you in the back of the van. Campsite here. Spoke to the landowners here, and he did give us permission. We've even got a 1 month fossicking license here. This gold panning took place down about a kilometer and a half down over that ridge there. But the gentleman said there was a homestead that was situated just to the top of that fig tree there, dating back to the early 1900s, late 1800s. So this property is. All this road takes down to where the gold fossicking and mining took place. So we're starting over near this old fig tree where the property owner said there was a homestead situated up in this region. We thought we'd just do a little bit of detecting around here. That was our campsite and fire that we had last night there. Did rain most of the night, but got a bit of an opening this morning. So we're gonna search around this old fig tree for a little bit and then go over the hill down to where the gold fossicking and the sites, they had sites there when they were doing searching for the gold back in the day. So there could be potentially old relics or coins or anything like that. We'll start with this tree first and up along the side of it as well. I think that people camping in this property throughout all the years have pretty thoroughly detected around that first area. So we come down through here. This looks like an area where there might have been some residency back in the day, and this road takes you right down to the creek where the gold mining and everything occurred when they set up camp down there. But I have found a signal here. This would be worth having a look. Got a bit of depth about it. Let's see what this one could be. Okay, that's what that one is. I think that's looks like an old grease nipple or something from machinery of some kind, by the looks of that. First interesting target. Make sure I fill these holes in nice and neatly, and then we'll keep exploring down through here. Well, we've come searching for gold nuggets at this old property and we found one. $2 gold nugget sitting right in the ground there. We're just on our way to head down this road. And I got a signal, knew it was only shallow, knew it was something more recent. But there we have it. First gold nugget of the day. Meant to be some real ones down at the creek down here. And another homestead, I believe, was situated around the corner here too. So we're just going to make our way down through here, see what we can uncover. Yeah, this is where the old mining area used to be down through here, gold mining. We've walked about a kilometer and a half up this track. Just go down through there, see if we can uncover anything. Mark just having a look around the old tree here for a moment. Look at that for an old relic here. Not even quite sure what that is. Don't know where that predates back to, but this was just against the tree there. We are having a bit of a look around here. There's heaps of the old lead heads off the old roof down there. About six or seven of them are found, so we're wondering if they did set up camp up on this area. Might be worth having a 10-minute look around this area before going down to where the gold mining occurred. So just detecting down here, Mark just went down there, but I was just having a swing around through here. And I have opened up 15 because we thought with this real old area there's a chance to find gold, and gold half sovereigns are 15. I mean, lead's 19, but look at that, 15. And I did scratch down in here. And I'll use this pinpointer. Look at that. That's no joke. That there, if I put the detector over that, you look at this. Look at that. And you feel the weight of this. That's heavy. You feel the weight of that. I think that's gold. It's not lead. Lead comes up as 19, and that's the same weight, if not heavier than gold. I reckon that's we're not going to say, but that's got some good weight about it, and that's coming up. I'll put it down here again. That was that 15, 16, and lead never comes up down there. It's lead's 19, so that's good. That's interesting. I was just sitting down a little bit under the soil down in here. Maybe one of the old gold people lost his nugget on the way up the hill.
It's like it's been melted.
I come along, because that's a little bit malleable too. You can actually just kind of nearly bend that. Is that, you able to do that with gold?
Should be able.
That's surely not, but surely that couldn't be gold. Look at that. Gold would usually, it comes up more of a shiny gold color than that usually, wouldn't it?
Should be more, yeah.
It has. Let's zoom in on that. Let's zoom on that. Is that lead or is that gold? Signal is 1516 on the Minelab Equinox 800. And this is a gold bearing area here, but yuppy. I'm not sure if that's a gold nugget. Who knows? You can be lucky sometimes. I've never found one before. But that is very heavy, slightly malleable, lower number than lead. Don't know. So I just uncovered this down in here. I don't think that's silver, it's too, feels light. Definitely got some patterning on there. But yeah, been finding a lot of these lead heads, so there's definitely some structures built down in this area. That's the next little discovery.
pretty old, whatever that is. Maybe it held two bits of leather together or something like that. Not quite sure. This neighbor's, this one here, it's like this spider's built a web and it's captured all these droplets of water. Isn't that interesting? And another man with a Equinox 900 detector came down here and I was speaking with him and he put his detector on this, we're thinking it's a nugget, and he seemed to think it possibly could be as well. It's heavy enough, but we come up with the conclusion that an old timer found his gold nugget staggered up this hill. Might have had a couple of homebrew beers, a bit of spirits or something, and staggered up here and dropped his nugget at the top of the hill, and I come along 80 years later, 100 years later, whatever it is, and found it. There you go. Okay, that's my next discovery. So Mark called me down there. We'll go have a explore, have a look at the mine shaft down here. Got workings from the mine. Oh shit. Don't want to fall down in there. Looks like Mark's gone down inside that one over there. Wow. Okay, we'll go for a explore down here. Is there tunnels that you can walk down in there?
No, it's
this shaft straight down. Did you see that one back there on the left?
No, I'm doing
that. That's pretty deep as well. Yeah. Wow. Interesting area. The other side of the fence here. You can see where they had the mining industry. Might be worth a look in through there as well. What's this sign say on the fence? Oh, maybe not. Don't know if we can go through that fence. But yeah, this is an interesting area. Dates back to the late 1800s, early 1900s when all this was occurring. I just come up through the scrub here, and I got another signal here. 15, that's that gold range again, and lo and behold, I don't know, that's got a lot of weight to it as well. I don't know, I always thought gold had, even coming out of the ground like that, had more of a gold sheen to it than that, but it's the same weight as gold. It's coming up as 15, lower than lead does. So I wonder if this is another little bit of gold, a little gold nugget. Not 100% sure, I'll have to show you Dad that he's cleaning them up. Hopefully it's not just a bit of melted lead or something, I don't think so. Sometimes you get what they call species or specimens that have got a mixture of the quartz crystal and gold inside there, or a mixture of a couple different elements together. Interesting. I'll keep searching up through here. So I just come up over this little ridge here. I nearly bumped into a friend here. He set up base here for a while. Disturbing too much, just doing its thing. That's Mark, might have found something down here, but look, you find something down there, Mark?
What's that?
Did you find something down there?
No.
Searching. Some lantana here, some old post, this one. I did find find that up against the base of it.
It's a bit of steel, small steel.
Have a bit of a search through here, see if I can find anything. So I just found something a little bit different here. Been finding a lot of the lead head, old style lead head nails from the galvanized iron usually. But that is something a bit different. Yeah, and the last one of these I found too. That's a different style than the other ones too. This one's. And up the side of this hill here. That's definitely not one of the lead heads off the nail that we've been finding. Much stronger. 25. I made one of these new coin target ID charts. Coming up as 25, so maybe it is just an aluminium lid or something, but could possibly be one of the old sixpence, no, 2.5%, 25. Silver rings, aluminium bottle lids. Let's have a look what it is. Damn, I was hoping that would be the first coin for the day. Had the hopes up there. Was in between numbers, so it was a bit of a mystery, but damn, don't even know what that is, but not an old pre-decimal coin, that's for sure. Okay, we came here early in the morning and we both stood there and dove in. So Mark's enjoyed it so much he's gone in again. Yeah, there he goes.
Beautiful.
Bit warmer than this morning or similar?
The surface top is, and yeah. Underneath a lot colder.
Very refreshing. It's a nice dam actually. We dove in early this morning before breakfast and swam right up the other side, got up on the bank. There's another dam behind there as well. Beautiful old fig tree here. Very refreshing. We come back and had a green tea and then some bacon and egg muffins and some nice brewed coffee. Now we're just having a cold beer and a rum can, relaxing in the afternoon. Nice property this, very relaxing, very peaceful. Okay, here we are climbing Mount Parry. The first section was about 1100 meters, pretty much straight uphill. Now we've gone into a nice little dense foresty, vine forest kind of area. There's, you hear the whip birds. This is a beautiful section up through here. Did they say it was a 7 kilometer return?
Yeah, it's only 7 return.
7 kilometer return journeys. Probably should take about 2 hours, 2 and a bit hours. Awesome. This is exactly 2 kilometers at the moment from the start. There's some people over there, they invited us over there, so it's a really nice look there. Haven't seen this spire. That's an interesting effect. Over the horizon, panoramic view.
This is prettier.
Yeah. We stayed up at big camp.
But they have no
just a
quite a drop down there.
You go on the Monto Road.
Yep.
You just go up the hill to the top and then to the right, and it's just there. And there, it's beautiful. Beautiful area, dam.
Okay, this has got to be the top. Actually, that was a bit further than what they said. It's coming up. Let's just hit 4 kilometers. 1 hour 20 minutes. We stopped a couple times. Good. There it is. Film that in case it's illegal what he's trying to do there. That was a big massive tree at some stage there. Actually there was a ladder.
Yeah,
nice safe ladder coming up there, so there wasn't a sign saying don't do it, but
there's a camera there.
No, look at the view up here, but that's... So what's that over there, an open cut mine?
Yeah, it's a gold copper mine.
Right, I'll just zoom in slightly. So this
all
is
the nasty EMFs out of the body.
It's the top of Mount Perry. Okay, we're just in the main township of Mount Perry, established 1871, general store. The old post office up there. And even along this whole side area here was a hub of activity back in the day. That's the old Federal Inn. All these areas are really old. We spoke to some people there and they said, oh yeah, go for your life. We'll just make sure we respect the ground here, but there's a high likelihood, depends how many other people have already done it, high likelihood of finding something in through here. We've got about an hour and a half before we're gonna head back up to Harvey Bay, so let's give it a go. Okay, first discovery, ironically, is a newer coin. We're certainly not after them. We're looking for the really old pre-decimals here. $2 coin, first find of the day. So I did just come over the other side of the road. This really old building here that's not occupied anymore. Looks like it's getting ready for demolition. Yeah, just so far found a few little old relics there. Not sure what all that is. But to go with that $2 coin, I did uncover a little coin here. It's just a 50-cent coin. Let's have a quick look what year this one is. Okay, that's just a 1984 50-cent coin. Okay, so just over against the side of the building here. Got a... ...17. And on this chart here, what is 17? It's not a 50-cent coin. So that... I think that has got to be... ...a silver threepence, actually. They usually come up as 16, this one's 17, but this I'd say is definitely a silver threepence, 1946 to 1964. So let's clean this one up to reveal exactly what it is. Let's get a little bit of the dirt off it first. Just gently scrape a bit of the dirt off it, then just put a little bit of lemon juice on it. Just let that dissolve in the lemon juice for a moment. Yeah, King George VI, That's Queen Elizabeth II's father, I believe. 1951, Australia, wheat threepence. That was 2 years before Queen Elizabeth II came into reign after her father, King George VI. Nice little silver coin discovered. Awesome. Only got another, probably about another 20 or 30 minutes left. So see if we can find one more, hopefully. I've uncovered another pre-decimal coin. 28, 29, so yeah, those are their kangaroo pennies. Let's have a quick clean of this and see exactly what year this kangaroo penny is. Okay, this is officially our oldest one so far. That's another King George VI. This time 1943. That's our oldest coin so far. Not long till I have to head back to Harvey Bay, so just keep searching for another 15 minutes. See how we go. And a local walked past here and he asked me how I was going, and I showed him what I'd found, and he said this was the old bakery. This particular place here used to be the bakery back in the day, so learned about the history of the town here. Now this is the next item uncovered. That's 22. Yeah, not sure what that is, but it's got a threaded hole on the other side. Very heavy. Interesting. So it's about 20 past 2. Bit over a 2 hour drive home, so might pack up, call that a weekend, or a long weekend. I want to go for a 10 kilometer run tonight, preparing for the Noosa half marathon in less than 3 weeks time, so, but that was good. Good little adventure, good experience. So I'll do an overview at home in the next day or two and put the video together from there. So here is an overview of some of the trash and treasures that was uncovered on the weekend treasure hunting and camping adventure at Mount Perry. We mainly focused on camping and enjoying being out in nature. We didn't do too much of the treasure hunting, but this is what we did uncover. Normal bottle lids, and these items here were found at the gold mining, the old gold mine area mostly, and they obviously had some little iron shacks and everything that they lived in at that gold mine area. So found plenty of the old lead heads off the nails they join on those sheets of iron, and they come up as about 19 or 20, so that nice sort of distinct circular small objects. So some of them sound like coins, so you gotta dig them anyway. So interesting to see some of the different shapes that you find. So these were interesting too. I'm pretty sure that's just lead as well, but we did find some certain crystals with different elements in. Some of them were sounding on their metal detector as well. My mate Mark found he's got it in his possession at the moment, but it's really heavy. I think it's got copper and potentially a little bit of gold in it as well. He took that one home, but that was a really good discovery. Probably heavier than the lead. Gold is heavier than lead, and I think, and heavier than the copper, of course. But it's interesting to find some of these items. These are old items you would have seen on the video itself. Mark also found that it looks like the bullet cartridge from a pistol round. You can see what some of what it says there, REM UMC 32 WCF. I'm not sure if that's a 32 caliber pistol round. I had a bit of an interesting couple of discoveries here with these two items. I was sure when I found that. Wasn't certain, but I was hopefully sure that it was a gold nugget, that one. But upon closer inspection, they were coming up as 15, which was the weird thing, because if that is lead, which we thought it must be lead, because when we scratched that gold kind of surface off, it was definitely looking more and more like lead underneath. But this has actually got a lot of weight to it, so the wishful thinking was that was a gold nugget, and that's pretty heavy as well. And that with this one here also was found in the gold mine area. A lot of weight to it, but as you can see there, unless there's a little bit of gold inside those two things, I'm pretty sure, unfortunately, that's not a gold nugget. We might actually, just for the novelty of it, I do have one of these things here, just for the novelty of it, even though we're sure it's not gold. Put that on there. 10.68 grams. .17 grams. So you can imagine if they were gold nuggets, 13.8 grams. But yeah, as I said, that would be very wishful thinking, as you can see there. Gold nuggets come up with definitely more of a sheen of gold. But you can see by the weight there, that's actually got a lot of weight about it. So, oh well, wishful thinking over. We did find 5 coins, a couple of $2 coins. It was a 1984 50 cent coin, and two great little discoveries at the end there. Was a King George VI silver coin that was found near the old bakery in the township of Mount Perry, 1951 wheat threepence. And then the oldest coin we got was a 1943. It's at 81 years old. Quite nice condition. Let's clean that up with a little bit of olive oil. King George VI, 1943 coin. So yeah, it was good adventure. As I said, it was mainly a fun outdoor camping adventure. Swimming in the dams and climbing mountains, and wouldn't mind going back to that Mount Perry area again and focusing just on the treasure hunting. And I think my mum and dad are keen to come out there as well. So all in all, very enjoyable long weekend.
shared in the company of a good mate. We finished the strength training class in the morning, then packed the van and off we went. So very worthwhile. So up until next time, thank you for following on the treasure hunting adventure series. Bye for now.
In the quiet of a shadow, in the corner of a room, darkness moves upon you like a cloud across the moon. You're aware in all the silence of a constant that will time, like the windmill left deserted, with the sun forever burned. So don't forget to breathe, don't forget to breathe. Real life is here, no 11th hour reprieve. So don't forget to breathe. Keep your head above water, but don't forget to breathe. And all the suffering that you've witnessed, and the handprints on the world, they remind you how it's endless, how endlessly you fall. And the answer that you're seeking, for the question that you found, drives you further to confusion as you lose your sense of ground. Don't forget to breathe, don't forget to breathe. Where all life is here, no 11th hour reprieve. So don't forget to breathe. Keep your head above water, but don't forget to breathe. To breathe, you know you are here, but you find you want to leave, so don't forget to breathe. Just breathe. Just breathe.